Hi, I'm Will Pringle, and together with Raphael Wiska-ilnicki, Andy Lee, and David Solis, we make up Team Slik. This semester, we designed an app for the Guelph First Response Team. The First Response Team, or FRT for short, provides emergency health services to the University of Guelph's campus. They operate 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, under the directive of the Campus Community Police and Fire Prevention. Our mission is to reduce paperwork and administrative overhead, allowing FRT to focus on what they are amazing at, first aid response. For the FRT first responders and supervisors, our goal is to make their work easier and more time efficient. With an emergency first response, seconds can make all the difference. For the administrative volunteers, our goal is to provide them with tools that simplify the work for them. We're primarily focused on scheduling volunteer shifts and paperwork intake. Our development process began when we listened to a presentation by the FRT on their current system and room for improvement they'd like us to address. We categorized the main functionalities for the software as filling out patient care reports, scheduling responder shifts, and tracking equipment usage. We also identified other functionalities to include a responder feedback system and the tracking of call statistics. With these primary and secondary functionalities identified, we started developing specific and measurable requirements that were representative of the components we established. We then categorized them into musts, coulds, and shoulds by identifying which ones represented the bare minimum specification, which ones were more advanced, and which ones were nice to have. We also determined things the software would not do in order to keep the scope manageable. We also assigned 5 different levels of priority to each requirement, and then found dependencies within requirements. Separately, we worked together as a group to assign time estimates to each requirement. Using that, we created 2 work products, an ordered requirements list and a Gantt chart-like timeline to plan our implementation. In order to help us come up with a list of features and conduct our lab demos, we created 3 distinct use cases that go over some of the main areas FRT mentioned in the presentation. One was a responder who wished to exchange your shift on November 27th, with another's on November 28th. Also, a responder reporting depleted equipment after a call. And finally, a responder filling out a patient care report. We conducted 2 lab demos and iterated on our design each time. During the first demo, our participants pointed out areas for us to change in the next iteration. For example, the participants noted it would be helpful to quickly recognize if a shift on the View Shifts page was a day shift or a night shift. One of the volunteers also pointed out it would be useful to view shifts on a mobile phone. With this in mind, we created sun and moon icons to easily differentiate between day and night shifts and also made the page more mobile friendly. Another participant pointed out it doesn't make sense to delete feedback and instead suggested a system to archive feedback and view it at a later date. The archiving feature acts as a recognition that the responder has viewed and acknowledged the feedback. For the second demo, we increased the visual fidelity of our wireframe and implemented the feedback from the first demo. During this session, every volunteer suggested it would be more helpful to quickly see the attached call log information that relates to the feedback. We implemented this by adding a button that pops up the call log. We also made changes to follow AODA and PIPTA guidelines that I will discuss shortly. Throughout the development of our application, we considered standards outlined in the Accessibility for Ontarians with Disabilities Act and Web Content Accessibility Guidelines to guide our design decisions and allow our application to be accessible for users with disabilities. Our application's design addressed AODA's highest standards in perceivable, operable, understandable, and robust design. We ensured that color is not the only way of conveying visual information in our design, and made sure to use commonly recognized symbols and clear, simple text to explain what buttons do. The color combinations of text and backgrounds affect the contrast and readability of content in the application. This is why we made sure that the contrast of our text had a ratio of at least 7:1 for all elements, complying to level AAA standards. This is all while matching the university's colors of maroon, yellow, and black. Content in the application is organized with clear section headers to explain to the user what they're looking at. We also made sure that these headings, as well as other elements, are consistently identifiable with our interface and interfaces that our users have previously used. In consideration of PIPTA guidelines, we added the ability for users to log in with 2-factor authentication, which requires them using a unique PIN number, in addition to their password when logging in. This is in following principles of identifying purposes and safeguards. In addition, we only ask users for information that is truly needed for the application. Our system follows the requirements set out by the FRT and exceeds in coming up with some creative solutions. We fully implemented each feature FRT said they felt was lacking in the current system, and we even expanded on this with new ideas such as recording when feedback is acknowledged by a user. The supervisor that issued the feedback can detect if a user has read and acknowledged it. Beyond this, we excelled in closely following PIPTA and WCAG. Thanks for listening to our presentation.